calling. Tita Glo, when you first heard about what happened to Tito Ron, ano yung initial reaction?
I was shocked. Actually, till now, I'm still in that disbelief. Because I know Ronnie to be always in, you know, in a happy mood. You know, we did one series after the other. First, we did Los Bastardos,
right,
where I played his wife. Then I did Too Good to Be True, where I was his sister. I did not realize, but he had been texting, lunch, dinner, ano, kailan. But I was so busy doing Mayari.
Yeah.
So I said, run, sabi ko, I would text him, run. Okay, after I finish Mayari, which is right, siguro hectic tayo Christmas, sabi ko, right after Christmas, hindi, I'll not go out of town, ganyan-ganyan. I was always telling him, okay, we'll see you. So, siguro I texted him 4 days before this happened. Parang, but I hear that many people get very sad during Christmas. Yes, there is melancholy, it's solemn, it's, you know, also then you think back, even I go through that, I'm thinking, what have I done, where have I been, what did I do the whole year? But I never realized he could be that lonely.
Right.
Kasi we would go out, we went out a couple of times, you know, for dinner with my partner and everything. He was always masaya. So I'm just in a quandary. I still haven't gotten over it in truth.
Right.
But of course, I like to remember Ronaldo as masaya and super professional. Alam kong when I will work with him, I have to get my act together because I know that by the time we do the shot, you know, he knows everything.
Right.
Even
right.
His expressions, maayos na. After one rehearsal, siya na.
Yeah.
Diba? So, I know the kind, so I always look forward to work with him. I've done maybe, I don't know, 20, 30 films with him, plus sitcoms, and siya lagi ang partner ko eh.
Oh, wow.
You know, so I am so aware of him, whether we are bida, contra bida, whatever. So, what now?
Yeah.
He didn't even say goodbye. So I was really very, very shocked and still am.
Ano yung babaunin mong memory, Tita Glo, ng...
Statica.
Okay. Ano yung memory, Tita Glo, ni Kuya Ron, Tita Ron, ang babaunin mo?
Well, the one thing I remember with Ron before, besides the work ethics, that he's got the best work ethics, is I always remember him. Every time he sees me, he hugs me so tight. Yung talagang lahat, yung talagang serious, hindi right. lang yung pabeso-beso.
That's right.
Yung talagang he's a warm, he's a loving person. And the second thing I'll remember is that on the set, I was always warning him, don't eat everything on the set kasi yan, pagdating namin sa set, hahanap ng suman, hahanap ng siomay, kung may siopaw, kakain ng siopaw, at kung may bibingka dyan, titikim, kakape. Parang, sabi ko, Ron, you're eating everything, mamaya you'll be sick. I was always concerned about him.
Right.
About his sickness, about everything, and he listens naman, tapos kape nga, yung kape, you know, all of that. So, that's what I really remember about him eh.
Mm-hmm.
But I also remember on our last day of Too Good to Be True, parang he was very sad. I mean, lahat kami nagmamadali eh. Pero siya, he was very sentimental. He was very sad. He hugged me so tight, yung tight talaga eh. Yung kumbaga sa kwan, who can hug you like that? Maybe, I don't know if any other actor who's ever hugged me the way he does. And Ron was one of a kind. So, I never saw him in a bad mood, no matter how late.
Right.
Siyempre, gagalaw siyang mas mahina, pero always in good mood. Oh, ano, Glo, kaya natin. Kasi kami lagi ang magkabatuan eh, hindi ba? So, parang I'm just... he's left a void, you know. I think in every artista's who he has worked with.
Right.
You know.
Tita, yung yakap niya sa'yo ngayon, parang... when you look back now, it's some sort of like a goodbye na rin.
Well, when I see his picture, kasi I have a picture of him making me akap eh. Our friends took me akap.